I believe these people are known to you.
They're two of my school teachers. What are you doing here?
Where are we?
They must have followed you. That ridiculous school. I knew something like this would happen. We stayed in one place too long.
But why should they follow me?
Is this really where you live, Susan?
Yes.
And what's wrong with it?
But it was just a telephone box.
Perhaps.
And this is your grandfather?
Yes. Well, why didn't you tell us that?
I don't discuss my private life with strangers.
It was a police telephone box. I walked all round it. Barbara, you saw me.
You don't deserve any explanations. You pushed your way in here, uninvited and unwelcome.
I think we ought to leave.
Now, just a minute. I know this is absurd.
Dear, this is very unfair.
I walked all round it.
It stopped again, you know, and I've tried. Oh, you wouldn't understand, of course.
But I want to understand.
Yes. Oh, by the way, Susan, I managed to find a replacement for that faulty filament. Bit of an amateur job, but I think it'll serve.
It's an illusion. It must be.
What is he talking about now?
What are you doing here?
You don't understand, so you find excuses. Illusions, indeed. You say you can't fit an enormous building into one of your smaller sitting rooms.
No.
But you've discovered television, haven't you?
Yes.
Then by showing an enormous building on your television screen, you can do what seemed impossible, couldn't you?
Oh, yes, but I still don't...
Not quite clear, is it? I can see by your face that you're not certain. You don't understand. I knew you wouldn't. Never mind. Now, which switch was it? No. Ah, yes. That is it. The point is not whether you understand. What is going to happen to you? Well, tell everybody about the ship now.
Ship?
Yes, ship. This doesn't roll along on wheels, you know.
You mean it moves?
The TARDIS can go anywhere.
TARDIS? I don't understand you, Susan.
Well, I made up the name TARDIS from the initials, time and relative dimension in space. I thought you'd both understand when you saw the different dimensions inside from those outside.
Let me get this straight. A thing that looks like a police box standing in a junkyard, it can move anywhere in time and space?
Yes.
Quite so.
But that's ridiculous.
Why won't they believe us?
Well, how can we?
Now, don't get exasperated, Susan. Remember the Red Indian. When he saw the first steam train, his savage mind thought it an illusion too.
You're treating us like children.
Am I? The children of my civilization would be insulted.
Your civilization?
Yes, my civilization. I tolerate this century, but I don't enjoy it. Have you ever thought what it's like to be wanderers in the fourth dimension? Have you? To be exiles? Susan.